Hi, I'm the Rick and Rick Turns, and today I'd like to talk about Chucks.
No, not the Chuck TV show. No, not Chuck Norris. All right, we're getting a little warmer. A woodchuck? Now you're just being silly. Thank you. This is a woodturning chuck.
But before we get started, I'd like to answer a question from one of my subscribers. Fred from Connecticut writes, "Ricky, I've read about turning stone, like alabaster and soapstone. Have you ever tried turning stone?" First of all, Ted, my name is Rick, not Ricky. You're probably confusing me with my identical twin sister, Frederica, who did go by Ricky. Oddly, Ricky was 10 years older than me, and she died when I was only 8. She was a jello herder. Only thing she ever wanted to do with her life. Well, one day she was driving a large herd of jello from Abilene to the stockyards at Tucson, and something spooked the jellos. They panicked and stampeded. Over 1,000 head of crazed jellos knocked her off her horse and quivered right over her. She couldn't eat that much jello fast enough, and she was wobbled to death. Just another sad story of jello mortality. I know you're in heaven, sis, because there's always room for jello. To get back to your question, Ned, no, I have not and I will not turn while stoned. It's dangerous and it's illegal in every state except Colorado and Oregon. Thanks for writing, Red. Now let's get to work.
I've had a question or two lately about woodturning chucks, so I thought it would be useful to kind of provide an introduction to the woodturning chuck. Now, if you're an experienced woodturner, you probably know as much as I do about chucks. They're not that complicated, of course. But if you're a brand new woodturner, or if you've never had a chuck or never used a chuck, it might be a little on the puzzling side as to how they work and what features you need to look for if you're going to buy one. Now, these are the chucks that I have in my shop. This right here, this is the Nova Midi chuck. I have two of those, as you can see. One with small jaws, I think these are 25 millimeter, and one with a sort of the standard set of jaws, which is a 50 millimeter. This one right here is a Nova G3 chuck, and it's got a set of deep, and you can see that they are deep down in there, 50 millimeter jaws, which is good for holding longer work. And then this one right here, which I primarily use for turning large bowls, this is a one-way stronghold chuck. So let's take a closer look at these chucks and see what's unique about them. And we'll start with this one right here. When you buy a chuck, you probably get at least this many items. The chuck itself, of course, and it's really in sort of two parts. You've got the chuck body right here, and then you've got the chuck jaws right here. Most chucks that I've seen, when you buy it as a kit, say, come with 50 millimeter jaws. Now, these are quite a bit larger. This is about 4-inch jaws here, and that would be something like 100 millimeters. And I bought these. This one came with a 50 millimeter jaws. I bought the larger jaws because I do a lot of bowls or start out as blanks of about 13.5 inches. The swing on my lathe is only 7 inches, and so the maximum bowl or the maximum circle I can get on it is 14 inches. So do a larger piece of work like a large bowl, larger chuck and larger jaws are useful. It will also come with some type of tightening device. Now, the Stronghold and a lot of other chucks use this kind of toothed tool right here to tighten and loosen the chuck. And it goes into a hole in the side of the chuck body, and it engages into these gears right down in here so that when you turn the tool, it tightens or loosens the chuck. It's a very easy way to apply pressure to your holding. Most chucks will also come with this woodworm screw or just a wood screw. Doesn't really have an official name, I don't think. And this is for going inside the chuck. It would mount right in here. We'll see that later. It will mount right in there, protrude out beyond the chuck jaws. You don't even have to have the jaws on here for that. And then you drill a hole in the chunk of wood that you're going to work on and screw it on to the wood screw right there while it's on the chuck. Chuck has several different parts. As I pointed out, we'll use another one here. It's got a body and it's got jaws. That's pretty standard. Some chucks, a lot of chucks, as a matter of fact, have this. Now, this piece is an insert. The insert goes inside the chuck body like this. And the insert itself is threaded for the headstock spindle on your lathe. You have to buy this specifically for your headstock spindle. Mine is a 1 inch by 1/8 per inch. So that's what this one is. The reason the manufacturers do that is primarily so that if you buy another lathe, a larger lathe, or conceivably a smaller lathe, that has a bigger or smaller headstock spindle, you can just unscrew this from the chuck and put in a new insert and you're good to go. Don't have to buy a whole new chuck. Not every chuck has those inserts in it. The Nova MIDI lathe, the Nova MIDI chuck, see right here, it's direct threaded. There is no insert here. You buy this to specifically fit one headstock spindle. And if you switch lathes, you're going to have to buy another one because there isn't an adapter or anything, at least not from Nova. So back to the chuck. You've got the insert, the body, the jaws. And the G3 also uses a toothed tool for tightening and loosening. Goes right in there. And that's pretty much all there is to a chuck. It's fairly simple. Let's switch back to this one. The jaws themselves mount onto the, they mount onto the slide. I think that's what it's called. The slides are mounted into these grooves in the body. So when you are loosening and tightening the chuck like this, what's happening is those slides are moving in and out. So the jaws are tightened down onto it, usually with socket set screws like this. This large set of jaws here, you can see it's got two set screws per jaw. This one here, there is no room for two set screws. Well, yes, there is. Let me correct myself. This one here has got a set screw here and then a set screw down inside. So if the chuck jaws are big enough, they're going to have two set screws. If we look at this one right here, you can see it's only got one set screw. Smaller chuck, smaller jaws, one set screw. Never had a problem with it, even though it's only got one screw. It's quite tight, and the jaws are mounted in such a way on these slides that they're not going to come loose as long as they've got at least one screw in them. Also on the MIDI chuck, if you look at the larger jaws, now these jaws have more room in them. You can see right there. These have the mounting screw here and here. On this one, mounting screw on the outboard side, but there's really no room on the inside, and that's why it's only got one set of screws. The MIDI chuck uses bars for tightening. A bar goes in this hole. Two holes in the chuck, just like that. Then, as you move the bars back and forth, the chuck tightens and loosens just like that. Nothing wrong with that method, but it's a little clumsier than having the tooth tool. Because with the tooth tool, you can hold your workpiece in one hand against the chuck while you slip this inside with one hand and tighten it up. Works really well. This works well too, but sometimes I think I need three hands to fix it. I'm holding a workpiece here up against the chuck. Got this right here. Sometimes these things, the bars are not far enough apart to grip, or I can usually bring them in close. But eventually I'm going to have to let go of the workpiece to really apply pressure on there. So it's a little clumsier using two bars like that, but it certainly can be done. Now, if you're looking for a chuck, looking to buy a chuck or something, there's a few things that you should be looking for. First of all, the jaw size. Now, that's dependent upon the kind of work you're going to be doing. If you're going to be using turning small items, and I don't have a sample here, but I'll use a blank about like this for turning some Christmas ornaments. So obviously, this set of chuck jaws is not going to work real well for this blank. And so for one of my MIDI chucks, I bought the 25 millimeter jaws, which this fits very nicely in them. Tighten it down and it's good to go. For a little bit larger work, say you're going to make a weed pot out of this. So you really don't want to turn your tenon down to less than an inch to fit in here because it's not as strong. So you turn it down here and you put it in a set of 50 millimeter jaws. And it goes in right like this. You tighten it down. So just goes in just like that and tighten the jaws down on it. Gives you a very strong hole there. So the jaw size is one thing you're looking for when you buy a chuck, depending on the work you're doing. However, if you're buying the jaw as a, the chuck as a kit, so that you get the tightening device and the woodworm screw and so forth, then you're pretty much limited to 50 millimeter jaws. At least for a mid-range chuck like this, I think that's what most of them come with. That's not bad. It's a very common size and very convenient for a lot of work. If you're intending to do large bowls, then you probably want to get a bigger chuck with bigger jaws. But even the bigger chucks don't always come with large jaws. It's a separate purchase. $40 to $50, usually separate purchase. The insert. If you buy the chuck as a kit, you may get an insert with it, but probably not. Usually it's an extra cost option. I'm pretty sure it was for the stronghold here, and I'm pretty sure it was for the G3, but don't quote me on that. A couple other things to look for, of course, as I've shown, this one and this one, they have a tooth tool for tightening and loosening, so it can be, the tightening and loosening can be done with one hand while you're holding the work with the other hand. With these Nova MIDI chucks and some other very small chucks, you've got a couple of bars that you have to use to tighten and loosen to go in just like that. That's not bad. It's, I think, worth the savings in cost, but it also is a little bit clumsier to tighten and loosen this chuck while you're holding the workpiece up against it. Let's take a look at one other type of chuck. I just wanted to mention a few other types of chucks. This is called a Longworth chuck, and as you can tell, this one's homemade. They're not hard to make. A bit of a nuisance, but they're not hard. The Longworth chuck rotates like this. And it's got these rubber stoppers up on the top. So the idea is you're going to put a bowl in there. See if this one will fit. It's kind of a small bowl. This one won't fit there. So I would expand it. Put this down in there. This is the idea of the Longworth chuck. To be able to finish a bowl bottom easily using a chuck that's quick, that you can clamp down really quick. So you clamp that down, you go to the back of it, and you tighten down all the little nuts on there. So you can also get similar jaws for a regular wood turning chuck. And what they typically are would be four jaws that expand out like this and have a range of holes, and they come with a set of stoppers and to adjust the size within the range of the chuck. You have to move the stoppers back and forth by unscrewing them, putting them in, screwing them down again. The Longworth chuck addresses that. And you can buy these commercially. They tend to be expensive, $200 to $300. I tried making one. It works okay. I don't use it that much, but I haven't been turning any bowls lately either. There's a few other chucks. This is a lathe chuck as well. This is called a Jacob's chuck, and it's also called a Jacob's chuck when it's on a drill or a drill press or anything else. This has got a Morse 2 taper on it to fit my tailstock. Very convenient, but it's not for holding work on the headstock.
There are a lot of really good chucks that are available. I've mentioned One Way. I've got the Stronghold, and they have several other ones. Technitool produces the Nova line of chucks, of which I have the MIDI and the G3. Easy Wood Tools, fairly recently, within a couple of years, I think, has brought out a brand new chuck, and I believe they have really pioneered the chuck with snap-on jaws. You don't have to use screws to put the jaws on and off, and that is a really big advantage. I believe Technitool is bringing out a new line of chucks also with that same feature. Vic Mark has several chucks available. Sorby's got a chuck called the Patriot chuck. There's a new line of chucks called Bulldog. I've seen a line of chucks called Barracuda at one online store. And I think Woodcraft is carrying a line of chucks called Wood River. I don't think this list is 100% complete. I probably didn't find them all. But the idea is that there is a lot of chucks available if you're interested in purchasing one.